The last thing we gotta do is we gotta strengthen our muscles to create a robust knee to lessen the pain. That's the main goal. And for you to walk and do your daily activities a little bit better than yesterday.
Brown guilty eyes and little white lies. Yeah, I played dumb, but I always knew.
Hey guys, what's up? Dr. Kyle here again, and today's episode is going to be about knee pain. There's a lot of things that can cause knee pain because there's a lot of structures that make up your knee. So I'm going to be teaching you basic things that you can do to reduce your aches and pains. Number one is you need to reduce the inflammation and swelling if you have any of those. You do the Rice or Price method that I've been talking about in my previous videos. So again, you protect your knee, you rest, you protect the knee joint, you ice. So you place some ice on your knee to calm down the inflammation. You can put it in a Ziploc bag or any plastic bag, as you could smash the ice with a hammer, that way it's more malleable. Then you can take medications. I would recommend taking acetaminophen first or Tylenol. And then if that doesn't work, then you can proceed to like ibuprofen or Motrin or Naprosyn or Advil. That way it calms down the inflammation. You can also add compression to your knee by putting, you know, an ACE bandage wrap or something that could compress your knee. And then you can elevate your knee when you sleep. You can put 2 to 3 pillows. You're also reducing the swelling. And if you want to check out a more detailed video about this, you can click the link in my description. And I've placed all of that there, all right? Once the inflammation and pain has gone down, you can now proceed to working on your tissues or your muscles around your knee to calm them down. So I'm going to be showing you a couple of ways on how to do this. Because what happens most of the time when we get injured, our muscles become tight, they become weak. And then number two is moving your actual joint itself. So I'm gonna be teaching you ways on how to bend your knee and how to straighten your knee as much as it can. And the third one is stretching. Because as I've said, sometimes our tissues can be very tight, so you need to stretch those tight muscles. And then the fourth one is strengthening. Okay, that's the last one we're gonna do. Your muscles are nice and loose, they've been released. So you need to strengthen the knee and cement it down. That way your knee is strong, it's robust, and it can handle more load, therefore reducing knee pain. Without further ado, let's get right to it. One of the things also I'd recommend is that when you have pain with walking, is to use a walking stick or a cane. If you feel like you don't like to use a cane, then I would prefer, you know, just grab a pole or something that you can hold on to and just tell people that you're using a walking stick. Make sure that you're grabbing the walking stick to the opposite side. If you have pain on your left knee, use the walking stick on the right side. When you walk, when you step with the bad leg, this goes with the bad leg. So the bad leg goes in front as well as the walking stick. This goes together. The bad leg and then the walking stick goes together. Let me show you how it's done, all right? Bad leg and walking stick goes together. Then you step with a good leg. So if my bad leg's the left leg, then I go bad leg goes with a walking stick. All right, let me repeat. This is how you're gonna walk. Bad leg and walking stick. Good leg. And left arm. Okay, one more time. Bad leg and walking stick together. And then good leg. And then the left arm. So normal pace. Bam, 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 bam. Walking stick, bad leg. Good leg, left. The very first thing that I would recommend is massaging muscles around your knee. So you have the top of your knee, the side, the inside, and then your lower leg muscle, okay? For those of you who have a massage stick, I would recommend getting this. It's called a muscle roller or a massage stick. So you're grabbing the muscle roller, and then you're finding that top muscle right here on top of your thigh. Put in a little pressure, and then you just roll it up. And then on the side as well. I would recommend heating it up before first. You could also do this if you feel like it's very stiff. Then you could heat it for about 15 minutes with a hot pack. If you don't have a hot pack at home, you can put rice in a sock, microwave it, and that's gonna be your homemade hot pack. All right, so I would recommend doing this for about 5 to 10 minutes. 5 minutes on top, 5 minutes to the side, and then 5 minutes on the inside of your knee here. Okay. Then you can even go to your lower leg muscle here. And you can hit the inside. You can hit the back. Then you can also hit the side here. And you can, you know, right? Just make sure you're getting all those muscles that are, they feel like are tight. I would also recommend going a little bit slower on areas that are tight. And you can also hit the muscle at the back of your thigh here. The second thing that you can use is a muscle ruler. You can get this at Walmart. You can get this in an exercise store. I bought mine for about $8.99, so it's not super expensive. The darker ones are harder, and the lighter ones are a lot softer. So I prefer the dark ones because I need a little bit more oomph to my rolling, okay? So I'm gonna start down low here on my calf. The concept is you're still working on those tight tissues, and then I roll forward. I'm hitting the back of my lower leg. I could even go on the inside. And notice that I'm leaning back. That way, if I can take pressure off my lower leg, I feel like it's just a little bit too uncomfortable, then I just put more weight on my hands. I would recommend doing about 5 minutes. But if you don't have a lot of tightness on your lower leg, then you can do less. You can also point your toe up and down. Then you can move on to the back of your thigh. Higher. Same concept every time. You can hang out and go slower on areas that are tight. And you can go to the inside of your thigh by going here, and you're hitting the inside of your thigh, okay? Yep. Then if you want to go hit the outside, this is going to be a little bit more uncomfortable because you have a structure here around your knee. It's called your IT band. That can get a little tight. Just be careful. This can be uncomfortable. So from here, I still hit the side. Just do as much as you can tolerate. It's about maybe 5 minutes. Or you don't have to go 5 minutes if it's too much for you. You can go 1 minute and move your way up to five if you can, okay? Then you can hit the top of your thigh muscle as well. I go on fours and then I just roll it up here. Okay. I'm doing both legs at the same time just because it's easier for me, it's more efficient. Called your quadriceps, and I'm slowing down on untighter areas. Sounds good? Not bad, right? Cool. So if your muscles are very tight, I would recommend heat and then do these techniques, okay? Also, if you have any pain going down, starting from your kneecap all the way down to your lower leg bone or your tibia, you can find a structure here and you can do cross friction massage. So basically what you do is you grab your thumb, grab your other hand, place it on top of the thumb, and then you go perpendicular, you go left to right. You do that for about 5 to 10 minutes. I'd recommend doing this every other day. I wouldn't recommend doing it every day because It could be a lot on that structure, okay? So you go left to right. And then you can also hit that tendon here. You have a structure again that that sits on top of your kneecap, right in this area that attaches here. And then you can go again, you can go left to right. If you're blessed enough to have a massage gun, use this instead. That way you're not hurting your fingers. You can use it at a lower level setting, and then you still do the exact same concept with what you're doing. You're going left to right on that structure between your kneecap and your lower leg bone. You can do it for 5 to 10 minutes. Then you can also hit that structure between your kneecap and on top of your thigh, right on that area here. And then you can go 5 to 10 minutes still. All right. Sounds good? Okay. Perfect. So sometimes, guys, our knee can't bend all the way, especially for those of you guys who have arthritis or something that's blocking your knee. For example, for some of you who may have meniscus injuries, again, that's the marshmallow pad between your knees that gives you support. If you want to know a little bit more of the meniscus, you can click on the link below. So now that we've done with the massages, we've now worked on heat, we've now lessened the pain, we can now move our joints. We can now actually move and put pressure on our knee a little bit, especially if it's not bending all the way. So you're just moving your knee and you're bending your knee, and then you're helping your knee bone, your lower leg bone, move the way it's supposed to move. Prop your leg onto a chair or a stool, then grab onto the lower leg bone. You'll feel a little bump on the front part of your knee. Take up the skin slack, and then I want you to rotate clockwise towards your other leg. So grab again your lower leg bone, and then you're rotating inward clockwise as you're bending your knee forward. Let me show you. Right, I'm bending my knee forward, and then I'm rotating clockwise. I make sure I keep the tension on that clockwise motion. I don't let go. So I do about 15 repetitions. If that's too much for you, then go up to 5. And move your way up to 10. And then move your way up to 15 if you can. Okay, make sure I don't take off the slack, all right? I keep my hands here, and I keep bending my knee as far as it can go. Okay, let me show you a front view here, guys. From here, grab my two pointer fingers, take up the skin slack, bend forward and rotate to my opposite knee. Make sure that you're keeping that clockwise motion, rotating your lower leg to the other leg. And you can do about 10 to 15 times and keep repeating. If you can go farther, go even farther. Same thing on the other side. Rotate. Rotate. Keep bending. Bam! You can put a towel on top of that chair, place your leg on top of the towel, and then you put the grocery bag and tie it around your thigh muscle here. Try that. If you can tolerate 5 minutes, then go up to 7, then even up to 8 minutes, and then make sure that it's not painful and you feel that weight going down on your knee. Okay? Give that a shot. Great, grocery bag tight, towel, strain your knee. Chilling. Okay, make sure you feel the pressure going down. Okay? Cool. Once you're done with all those, we move on to stretching. All right, it's very important for us to stretch our muscles around our knee joint. So a good way to stretch the back of our thigh here is you grab the back of your knee a little bit lower, then you pull. Make sure that you feel the stretch on the back of your thigh, okay? Right here. It's called a hamstring stretch because you're stretching your hamstrings. And you stretch for about 30 seconds. Minimum stretch, go to, if you can only do 10 seconds or 12 seconds, that's fine. But make sure you're going to at least 30 seconds to a minute. Meaning you're holding it, I'm pulling. Once I feel that first resistance or a stretch, then I hold it there. Okay, then I let go. I do about 3 times, take a little break, maybe 30 seconds, and then bam. Go again, 30 seconds. 30 seconds to a minute, guys. If you can strain your knee like this, even better. Guys, if you feel like you have numbness and tingling going down your leg, if you feel like you're in more pain when you do this, then stop this exercise and move on to the next one. Okay, the goal here is for you to be out of pain, not to be in pain. Switch sides, 3 sets here, 30 seconds, 2 to 3 sets. And then if you can go to a minute, even better. And you let go, then you go again. Make sure that I feel the stretch in the back of my thigh, okay? Capiche? Sounds good. All right, let's move on to the next one, guys. The next stretch that I'm gonna show you is we're gonna be stretching the front of your thigh here, okay? Remember that we massaged it earlier, now we're gonna stretch it. So grab a belt, loop it around, then go on your belly, your stomach. Grab the belt, then I pull on my lower leg. Make sure that I feel that stretch on the top of my thigh, okay guys? Right there. I should feel it right there. And still, concept of stretches, guys, you wanna go 30 seconds to a good minute. And then you let go, relax, and then you pull again. Notice that I'm pulling with my opposite arm. Or you can do this, whatever you can do. As long as you're bending that knee. Guys, if you feel pain going to your back or to your butt, and if you feel like you have pain onto your pelvis, your hips, that is not a stretchy type of pain that goes in front of your thigh, then stop this exercise and let's move on to the next one, okay? It means your body's not ready for this yet. 30 seconds to a minute, okay? Then switch sides. You do about 2 to 3 sets. What's up, guys? I had to move the camera a little bit down. That way you could see me. The next stretch that we are gonna do is we're gonna stretch the bottom, the lower leg muscle, your calf muscle, right here, okay? Remember, guys, that this calf muscle attaches to your knee joint as well, and if it's tight, it can cause a lot of problems. It can cause even pain. So let's stretch it out, all right? So grab something that you could hold on to. If you want to stretch your left calf muscle, straighten your back leg like so, and then you lunge forward, keeping your heel, my left heel or the leg that I'm stretching, planted on the ground. Then I lunge forward. Make sure that I feel a stretch on my bottom leg. If you feel any numbness or tingling or pain that shoots up, or any kind of pain that's weird, it's not a stretchy type of pain, then stop this exercise immediately. But more so than often, a lot of people like this stretch, they tolerate this. A lot of runners, a lot of people, because we're on our feet. So I just noticed here that I just switched legs, right? Very easy to switch. Make sure that I keep my heel planted on the firm on the ground. Again, the stretches are held. How many minutes? No, how many seconds? 30 seconds to a minute. If I want more of a stretch, I lunge forward with my left knee now. Bam. If I feel like my heel is getting off the ground, then I'm not doing the correct stretch. Then switch. 30 seconds. And then you lunge forward. Perfect. Another stretch that you could do if you want to add more, if you have time, is you can bend this knee a little bit. So you bend it. You don't have to go all the way back. You could go halfway. Bend this knee, the back knee, and then you lunge forward. And you should feel a stretch on the lower leg muscle, like a little bit lower and a little bit deeper than before. Hold it for about 30 seconds to a minute. Switch. Halfway, bend my knee, my back knee. I bend it, and then I should feel a stretch on my lower leg muscle, a little bit lower and a little bit deeper. Now that we're done with stretching, loosening up all the muscles and, you know, moving our joints, the last thing we gotta do is we gotta strengthen our muscles to create a robust knee to lessen the pain. That's the main goal, lessen the pain and for you to walk and do your daily activities a little bit better than yesterday. All right, so my favorite is the mini squats. You can grab your walking stick with you, and then you just do mini bends with your knee. Let's not make this complicated. Feet shoulder width apart, turn your toes out a little bit, and then you pretend you're sitting on a chair, and it goes straight down. I'm sitting on a chair, and go up. I'm sitting on a chair, go up. I'm sitting on a chair, go up. I feel the pressure at least at the back of my heel or in the middle part of my foot. Again, one more time. I'm sitting on a chair, go up. I'm sitting on a chair, go up. Do about 10 to 15 times. If you can't do 15 again, guys, then go up to 10. Make sure you're doing this consistently. Do about 10 times, take a break for maybe 30 seconds to a minute, and then you repeat one more time. You repeat those 15 repetitions again. Okay, one. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Bam, that's it. Side view with your walking stick, pretending I'm sitting on a chair. One. Mini bend, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Bam! Try that out. I felt the burn. You should feel the burn too. You should feel the burn or your muscles working in front of your thigh, your butt, the back of your thigh. Last exercise that we're gonna do, guys, is we're gonna have to strengthen your lower leg muscles, your calf. We stretch the calf out, we loosen it up, but we also gotta strengthen it because you walk every day, that's your walking muscle. We gotta hit those too, all right? So very easy, guys, very simple. All you're gonna do is you're gonna go up on your tippy toes. That's it. So shoulder width apart. Grab onto a table if you have to, or you can grab onto your walking stick and then just go up to your tippy toes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. You get the idea. Go up to 25 times, guys. That should be the magic number. Let me show you from behind. Tippy toes. One, two, three, four, five. Go up to 25 again. And try all those, see how that goes for you. I'm sure and I'm positive that you're gonna love it. If you do these consistently every day for the first 2 weeks, as soon as your pain lessens, then you can wean off to maybe 4 to 5 times a week. And then lessen it to 2-3 times a week when you feel like the pain has gone down significantly. And then I would recommend you doing these for the first 2 to 3 weeks, I would recommend do these 2 to 3 times a day. That way you can get better at it. Making sure that you're being consistent with these things and incorporating it in your daily life. Okay? Gotcha. All right, guys, that's about it. Thank you very much for being with me here today. If you have any questions, feel free to comment below. Like this video if you like this. Share this with your friends and family. Subscribe, ring the bell, all the good stuff. And share it on Facebook, share it on Instagram. It would really help me out. It would really gain more coverage. And we could also help other people. Share it with your family and friends. And if you have any friends or family members that you feel may benefit from this, feel free to share this with them too. That way they too can be pain-free. Alright guys, again, my name is Dr. Kyle. Spread the word. Be safe. Take care. And it's almost half a year. Time flies. Needs a speeding ticket. Anyway, hopefully you guys are pain-free and are staying safe out there. Keep up the good work, and I got your back. Bye.
That you talked to her, maybe did even worse. I kept quiet so I could keep you. And ain't it funny how you ran to her the second that we called it quits?